Across the salon, Audrey meets a second-time bride with her blended family in tow.
Hi, Audrey. Very nice to meet you.
So nice to meet you. I'm Cher England. This is my second marriage. I'm here because I've met the man of my dreams.
Hi, Michael. A pleasure.
Want our wedding to be not just focusing on the bride or the groom. I want the focus to be on our family and how it came together.
Who are they?
We're almost like the modern-day Brady Bunch, is what we've been told. I myself have my oldest daughter, April, from a previous marriage, and then Michael has his children from his previous marriage, Alyssa, Katie, Matthew, and then together, Mike and I have our daughter,
Gracie.
We always knew our parents would get married.
The children have been asking me, you know, what are you waiting for, Dad, for a few years now?
It's about time they get married.
I'm gonna be a flower girl.
This wedding's very much about all of us together.
Oh, what a beautiful family. So, tell me, what are you looking for?
Something classy, elegant. I'm looking for the poofy, gorgeous ball gown.
So, Mike, what do you see?
Yeah, just something that's sexy, hot-looking stuff, basically.
Okay.
I really am looking for my family to say, yes, I really like this dress.
So Cher's looking for a ball gown. However, her fiancé, Mike, really wants something tight, fitted, and sexy. So we'll have to wait and see where this goes.
Mike knows sexy when he sees it, so he starts his own search.
There's that one, I think.
Yes. Oh.
This one?
I believe I know what her tastes are. I like them both. The one on the end.
I could see her wearing that.
Okay.
Cher slips into Mike's pick, hoping this will be the dress to please all.
You don't like it?
No. I guess this is what I was trying to stay away from. You know, I don't go for clothes that are skin tight.
Ooh, here comes.
Wow. That looks fun.
Oh my gosh.
Do you like this one?
This is definitely my favorite one.
She looks beautiful, hot.
I love this.
I like it a lot too.
Oh, now you like this one?
Dress two is this bunch's favorite.
I think it's between this one and the first one.
But Cher is still thinking about the ball gown.
The big puffy ones, you hide your body.
We'll be back.
Cher returns to the fitting room, unsure whether to please her family or herself.
So, do you think this dress knocks this dress out?
I don't know.
I like that one the best so far.
It looks good.
When Jennifer originally came to the salon,
dress number one.
She fell in love with a dress right away.
She looks absolutely stunning. She looks really fantastic.
But one small detail was missing.
But you wanted one strap.
I like the back on this one. I like the front on the first one.
So Diane found a way to give Jennifer everything she was looking for.
We're cutting and pasting.
So what we would do is purchase some of these flowers separately and then do a strap for you on one shoulder and add the flowers on.
Yeah. Okay.
With her dad by her side, Jennifer had her dream dress. This time, she's brought her fiancé, who redeploys to Afghanistan immediately after the wedding.
We're excited for the wedding, and we're really looking forward to it, but we don't want it to get here too soon, because that means he's leaving sooner.
Hi, Jennifer.
I'm Brian.
Hi, Brian.
Nice to meet you.
My fiancé's name is Brian. He is a pilot for the Army.
The couple have been inseparable since overcoming difficult hurdles.
Brian was back from Iraq for 2 weeks, and he was hit head-on by a minivan. Once we were sure he was gonna be okay, we just knew that we didn't want to wait anymore.
You would like to see the dress?
I would like to see the dress. I'm not allowed, though.
Okay. Come, Jennifer, with me.
I'm a little nervous because I'm having, you know, some stuff done to it.
Your beautiful gown here.
It can be nerve-wracking combining two dresses into one because you really don't get to see the dress until it's completely finished.
Can I put it on?
I can, of course.
Let's just hope that she really loves it.
Check the mirror, Jennifer. And it's gonna be the same material and color. What do you think?
Yes.
Okay.
That's perfect.
Perfect.
Okay. So exciting, I can't even.
Okay.
The dress is perfect.
The length is good, you see?
Yes. It's just kind of like exactly what I pictured in my head. I feel like a Grecian goddess.
I wish my dad could be here.
Where is your dad?
He's in Washington.
Oh, okay.
He came to the first one.
Surprise. He's good.
Oh, I love it.
My Jennifer.
Okay.
Oh, honey, that is stunning.
You look beautiful.
Really?
Oh, absolutely. Can I touch it?
You can touch it.
Oh, my God. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful dress, and she was so excited, but it didn't fit exactly like the sample fit. This it needs to be a little tighter. You need a little more uplift or something. I've always had an eye for fashion, and all I was trying to do was interpret what she wanted to make sure she got the final product. I think it's a little too much veil, like on the side. Yeah, you kind of wanted it just in the back a little bit. Isn't that what you wanted?
Just a dress.
Yeah, is that what you wanted?
I think if a fiancé is really kind of taking over the fitting appointment, I'm sure it only makes the bride a little more uncomfortable, a little more anxious.
What do you call me, Groomzilla?
We go with Groomzilla.
She calls me Groomzilla. One of the decisions that Sherry and I had to make is how big to make the train. So that was very dramatic. Decision.
Brian thinks the train is too long, so Sherry calls in alterations manager Vera to give an expert's opinion.
My personal opinion, you have to leave the train because the train, it is a part of the beauty of the dress.
Hi, I'm Antonella.
Hi, nice to meet you.
My name is Autumn Levine. I definitely want over the top, something that'll outshine like any other bride.
This is my fiance,
Hi, how are
Sunny.
You? Welcome.
My fiance's name is Sunny Mukhopadhyay. I met him in college 10 years ago. I really believe that he will love me no matter what. Like if I fall on hard times, if I get fat.
Honey, give me a kiss.
Uh-oh.
Hi.
You know how much I love you, right? So much. Give me another kiss.
Oh God, this is gonna hurt. This is really, really gonna hurt.
Autumn's bill includes her two dresses, an $8,000 veil, and the alteration charges.
So, grand total of this is $50,111.62.
Sunny's in a state of shock. Sunny's both speechless and possibly bankrupt. Sunny's feeling regret about the fact that he's gonna have to sell his kidneys off.
Don't you want me to look beautiful on my wedding day? Is that important to you?
I also want to eat.
He'll be okay. So if he has to wash dishes for 7 years at a restaurant to pay it off, that's what he's got to do. No, I'm kidding.
Autumn's happiness cost Sunny a hefty $50,000.
Sunny was going to try and talk Autumn out of it. He really does want to see her happy.
So hard to say no to you.
So then don't.